Now that we have our time model and our calendars created on our plant objects in our plant view, the next thing that we need to do is create a user interface and in runtime create templates for what our production day is going to look like. So we'll go to our devices tab, and we already have a PieShift calendar placeholder screen. So we're going to add a plant overview object and just kind of size it appropriately. We don't have a ton of objects, so that'll probably work. I'm going to kind of scale this down a little bit, and I'll add a calendar control. Now there's a lot of stuff on this calendar control, so I'm just going to kind of make it big so that we can see everything. And importantly, if we look at the properties of our calendar control, notice its name is calendar control 1, and we have to link it over here to our plant view object. So if you go to your plant view object and go to properties, we're going to scroll down and we're going to open the companion controls. So we'll do add new and control type calendar view. And then we'll pick out calendar control 1. So that's going to link these two controls. So when I click on conveyor, then it's going to show the calendar for conveyor 1 or conveyor 2 or whatever I have. Then I'm going to hit save project. Now previously we had saved and downloaded to the PLC. So make sure you've done that before you do this step. So I'll go ahead and I'll start simulation on my runtime object. And I'll click load. And then in runtime, we'll go to the PieShift calendar. And I'll click on line 1 conveyor. So now we have a calendar coming up under planning. It doesn't have anything on it yet. And that's because we need to add some stuff. But first, we need to make some templates. So we're going to go to the templates tab. Now notice here under categories, we've got all of our bottom level nodes that we can use to plan what a normal production day looks like. Now, one of the things that kind of threw me when I first started working with this is notice how it says add new shift and it starts seemingly at midnight to 8 o'clock in the morning. And I kept trying to make that go to, you know, 9 a.m. through 5 p.m., which is when my shift was. It doesn't matter. You don't have to worry about that. The way it works is we're going to pick our production category over here and drag and drop it. And just we're creating a normal shift. So what really matters is the number of hours versus what time of day it is. So for normal production, we're going to start when the shift starts. And I am holding down my left mouse key. And you can see it's telling me how many minutes this area is. So let's say that we work for an hour and 45 minutes. And so the first time I drop something, it's going to ask me to name this shift. So I'm just going to call this first shift, and I'll just repeat that here for the display name. I'll just call it production and just click OK. And let's say after an hour and a half, they get like a 15 minute break. So we'll call that a scheduled stop. So I'll drag this out. And so I'm holding my left mouse key and I'm dropping it. And then I'm moving the mouse and holding down the left mouse key to kind of make this as wide as I want. And so I want to go to, say, 201 or something like that. That'll give them a 15 minute break. And sometimes it gets a little hard. Notice I've got a gap in there, but I can right click on this and say snap left and it'll go right up against it. And then we're going to resume normal production. If you overlap, sometimes it kind of moves these things around. So it's a little bit of an art. So we're going to go from 2, say maybe to 3:45. I'll let that go. I'll right click, snap left. Let's call this lunchtime. So go back to scheduled stop. And that's going to go 3:45. Let's say that we give them an hour for lunch. So 3:45 to say 4:46. Snap left, and then we'll go back into normal production. Give them about an hour and a half of production. Give another break. And then we'll finish it out. I'll just go ahead and snap these left, and then we'll finish out the shift with normal production. And notice how it doesn't go beyond that 8 hours. And that's because we defined our shifts on the calendar for the plant objects to be an 8 hour shift. So I'll snap this left and I'll just make sure this guy comes on out. And then I can save this. And so it kind of goes from the lighter color with the dotted line showing you it's in progress to this is what our actual shift looks like. So we've got a template for our first shift, and we're going to create a second shift that looks exactly the same. Okay, so you see I've created a second shift that's pretty much the same as the first shift. And we can go ahead and add, say, a maintenance day. Let's say that we do maintenance on the weekends or on holidays or something like that. So we can create a maintenance shift. And let's just say we do maintenance all the way up till lunch. So let's just call this maintenance shift. And then we'll do a stop for lunch. And then we'll do maintenance for the rest of the day. I'll snap that left, kind of even everything up, and then I'll hit save. So we've got our shifts defined. We can take this a step further and plan out what our day looks like. So I'm gonna click on our day definition. So we'll just pull out first shift and we'll just call this production day. And we'll pull out second shift. So this will be normally what we do on days of the week. And then we'll have, say, a weekend day. So we'll do maintenance shifts. So we'll do two maintenance shifts there. And we'll hit save. Another thing that we can do is actions. And these are actually a pretty neat feature. They allow you to do stuff with your loud interface tags from your plant objects when a shift starts or ends or whatever you want to do. So let's say that when a shift starts or when a day starts, then we need to turn our conveyor on. So we can just kind of pull this out. Let's call this start production. And when I drag this out, it's going to give me the start time and I can choose the state. So let's say that our conveyor gets turned on and our motor also gets turned on just right after that. So we'll say it gets turned on, say, 5 minutes later. And then our pump, let's say it also gets turned on here. Say 15 minutes later, it goes true. And that's our start production. And then we could say we have an end production. So that would mean that our conveyor, let's call this end production. So our conveyor would be set to false, as well as our motor state. I want to say that's 5 minutes after. And then our pump state, say 10 minutes after. And we'll save that. So now we've got some production days, we've got some maintenance days, we have some actions that involve our interface variables. The next task is going to be actually setting up the calendar. So now it's your turn. Build your shift calendar screen using a plant view object and link it to a calendar object. Make sure your PLC is running and take your project to runtime. Navigate to your calendar screen you just created and select your conveyor to show the plant object calendar. And then open the templates tab. Create the first and second shifts like we did in the video, as well as a maintenance shift. Be sure to save. From these shifts, switch your view to day view and create a production day with your production shifts and a maintenance day with your maintenance shifts. Then create a start production and end production action template, turning on the conveyor, motor, and pump for start production and turning it off for end production. Make sure you save your templates as you create them. In the next section, we will use these templates you create to fill out our production schedule.